Everyone, it is Brother Brett Potts. Welcome back to this week's episode of Pray for Japan. Today we're going to talk about the prefecture of Kanagawa. Kanagawa Prefecture has a population of 9,160,000 souls. There are approximately four towns that have no churches whatsoever, and our missionary ratio for the Kanagawa Prefecture is 1 to every 77,627 souls. So as you can probably guess from my shirt and the picture behind me, the Kanagawa Wave is a big part of the Kanagawa Prefecture, and known just behind me, the artwork is actually one of the most famous pieces of art in Japanese art history. I just thought it was fitting that it fits with the Kanagawa Prefecture of today's video. So, Kanagawa Prefecture has some mild temperatures in the Saigami Bay, and then moving into the mountains, it's colder with heavier rainfalls, and it is also home to Yokohama. Yokohama is the second biggest city in Japan besides Tokyo, and it is the birthplace of Japan's cultural reform. So Kanagawa is very important spiritually. It has the strong Shinto and Buddhist beliefs that follow along with the rest of Japan, and it's a very conservative prefecture for these beliefs.
Kanagawa is also home to the great Buddhist statue in Kamakura, as well as the Hazakana statue. These are two of the great religious sites in the Kanagawa Prefecture and play a great part in their religious heritage.
First thing we want to pray for is the COVID-19 situation that continues to cause an epidemic around the globe. We would just want to pray that God would move on the situation and remove it completely from our world, and just open up the lanes of travel for missionaries and for churches to be able to go about into this world and just spread the word of hope and spread the hope of Jesus in these times. The next thing we want to pray for is our churches in the Kanagawa Prefecture. So we want to pray that God would just move in these churches and help them to grow, and that there would be open doors for church planters and evangelists and Bible teachers to just come into the Kanagawa Prefecture and open the doors and just spread the hope of Jesus in this prefecture and in a mighty way, just like the picture of the tidal wave of the tsunami, the Kanagawa wave. We want the wave of the Holy Ghost, the Kanagawa wave of the Holy Ghost, to move on the Kanagawa Prefecture and touch the hearts and minds of the people in the prefecture, that they would just feel the love of Jesus and turn towards Him. So the next thing that we want to pray for is our Christian families. And this is something that we, is a new topic this week, is our Christian families. And being a Christian in Japan is quite difficult. There's a lot of social pressure to kind of conform with being a Shinto or a Buddhist believer in the Japanese islands. However, it's very hard on Christian believers that are the only Christians in their household or the only Christians inside of their family. So we want to pray for these Christian believers that God would just touch and uplift them in a way that would make them feel like they could witness and be bold in their witnessing to their family. So just remember to pray for those Christian families. Next thing we want to pray for is our Christian schools. We always pray for our schools, and we pray that God would just reach down and touch on those schools, and that He would help them to be a light in this darkness and just move on the students and help them to be able to interact with their teachers and their other students and even their families to impact their lives for the gospel of Jesus Christ. Next thing that we want to talk about is our hospitals, jails, orphanages, nursing homes, facilities for the blind, food banks, that type of thing. Any type of a Christian ministry service like that, we want to pray that God would just move in these and use them in a way that would bless the people of Japan, so that they could see compassion and love and caring and just see the love of Jesus moving in a way that would meet their needs and would help them feel the love of Christ in a way that would help them connect to the gospel of Jesus. And we want to pray that God would move not only on the people that are at these facilities and need to use the facilities. We want to pray for the workers of these facilities, the volunteers, that God would move on them and He would move in a mighty way on their lives and just help them to feel the love of Jesus and feel the hope of the gospel in their lives. The fifth thing we want to pray for is for our English classes. And many of these English classes are taught by missionaries, taught by missions associations, taught by Christian organizations. And for many of them, they use the Bible as a textbook. And this is many people's first exposure to the Bible, is through these English classes. It's their first time reading the Bible, being associated with the Bible, or even knowing what a Bible is. So we want to pray for these Christian English classes And we want to pray for all the teachers, the instructors, the people that are taking the courses, that the missionaries that are teaching it. We want to pray for them that they be able to kind of answer some questions that the students would have about the Bible, and take the opportunity to turn questions that are about words or phrases into a Bible study about the Bible, about the grace of God, about salvation. And we just want to pray that God would move on those and touch in this situations, and just use this English courses, these English chances to teach English, as a chance to promote the gospel and share the gospel in these classes. Tagging on with our English classes is the teaching English as a second language or as a foreign language programs, commonly known as TESOL. And we want to pray that God would just move on these and help our short-term missionaries, our aimers, and help them to be able to find financial means to take these courses and get certificated and get official in the program in order to teach and be an instructor of teaching the English language as a second language to Japanese, because this can be, as we mentioned before, a big area of outreach. And I actually know of one associate missionary in the island of Miyako who actually used English classes and has taught English classes as a way to help propel the gospel in the Miyako, in the Ryukyu chain of islands in Okinawa. And this can be a powerful witness, a powerful tool. So we want to pray that the blessings of the Lord would just be upon all those that are seeking TESOL certification, and that God would just have his hand and use it to his glory in the islands of Japan. The sixth thing the Operation for Japan prayer guide has for the Kanagawa Prefecture is pro-life organizations, and we want to pray for all those across Japan. As being a apostolic Pentecostal Christian organization, we stand on a pro-life stance, and we want the blessings of God to be on those organizations, and use that as a chance to reach out to individuals. Last thing we're going to pray for today is for Japanese to read the Bible. As we've mentioned multiple times in our series, only 2% of the population of Japan is Christian. And so you can imagine that even a far less of that has probably even read their Bible, let alone opened or held a Bible. And we want to pray that there would be a moving of the Holy Ghost, maybe even through this coronavirus situation, to propel the Japanese to be interested in the Word, to read their Word, study their Word, and to just get questions. Even just having questions about the Bible. What is the Bible? What is it about? What does it contain? Because these things can move along in a situation, and these kind of questions can propel and elevate the Japanese to a place where they will contact a missionary or a Christian believer who's a friend and say, "Hey, I need you to tell me about this. What does this mean? You know, what does this mean?" And so we want to pray that God would just open their hearts and their minds as unbelieving Japanese begin to open their Bibles and read them, and that the grace of God would be upon them and the mercy of God would be upon them to find salvation, and that they would just fall in love with the Word and fall in love with Jesus. Thank you guys for joining us on another episode of Pray for Japan. This week was Kanagawa Prefecture. We talked about the Kanagawa Prefecture, some of the needs and some of the situations going on there and across the islands of Japan that we would like to invite you guys to pray with us about and help facilitate the Holy Ghost moving in these last days in the Japanese people. We believe there's a mighty revival headed towards the Japanese islands, and we want to see the work of the Lord done in the nation of Japan, a church in every prefecture that believes the apostolic message and believes the hope of Jesus Christ. And we're believing God for this vision in these last days. Next week, we are going to cover more prefectures. Look for the Chibu area coming up later on this week. We'll have a short video on that. And go ahead and like and share this video. Get the word out there. Let people know that there is a need in the nation of Japan. And we, as prayer warriors, as missionaries, as believers, can bind together with the people on the field and work with them and help them reach the Japanese with the hope of Jesus Christ. Thank you, and God bless.